What makes soft plastic bait so great is not necessarily the bait, but the way you rig them. They're very, very versatile in the way you can rig the bait. The four most popular ways of rigging a soft plastic by far is a Texas rig, a Carolina rig, rigging them with a jig head, or rigging a swim bait. Now there's plenty of other ways to rig a soft plastic, but if you master these four, then you're gonna be able to fish anywhere in the water column and fish just about any season and just about any lake, stream, or river in the country. You know, bass anglers have literally hundreds of baits to choose from. A successful day out in the water often hinges on picking the right bait for the right situation. Unfortunately, it's easy for an angler to make the wrong choice when they don't fully understand the nuances of rigging and presentations. In this Beyond the Bait video series powered by our friends at Streamlight, I'm going to offer a uniquely technical focus on the best baits for bass fishing. Along the way, I'll try to dispel many of the wives' tales, myths, and misnomers associated with bass fishing. Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Kuhn, editor in Game & Fish magazine. Come along as I attempt to help you put more fish in the boat. Now let's get to it. Swim baits have become very, very popular of late, and there's a reason for that. They catch all kinds of fish. Why do they catch fish? Because they look like a fish. They swim like a fish. In many cases, there's manufacturers that make them smell like fish. They are a great bait because they mimic the natural forage that bass are they're eating, whether it's a shad or a bluegill or a shiner. Bass love them. To rig a swim bait with a lead head, in this case, an underspin, which is nothing more than a lead head with a spinner on it underneath, hence underspin. You take your soft plastic swim bait and you insert the hook in the head, you pull it through, and then you push the hook out like that, and you push the bait down the hook like that. And the most important thing when rigging a swim bait is the fact that you get it straight. It has to be in line. It can't be curled over the hook. It can't be short on the hook. Because what that does is when you're fishing the bait will get a really weird torque to it, or it'll spin, or it'll do very odd things and it won't spin right. So make sure when you're rigging your bait, make sure that you get it straight on the hook so it swims right. Another advantage of a swim bait is the fact that they're great for finding fish. You cannot catch a fish if you don't know where he's at. If you can't find him, you can't catch him. If you're not fishing where they're at, they're not gonna bite and you're not gonna catch them. And a swim bait covers a lot of water really quickly and very efficiently because you're essentially casting it as far as you can cast it and you're reeling it in and you're covering a lot of water. Cover a lot of water, you're gonna find a lot of fish, and a swim bait's a great way to do that. Some advantages of swim baits are, among the other ones we've covered, is the fact that you can rig them just about any way you want to. You can use a swim bait hook that has a keel weight that can be hooked weedless, which means you can fish anywhere because of the size of the bait. It's a compact bait. It doesn't have any appendages, which means it's not gonna catch any weeds or stick-ups or stumps, limbs, logs. It's very, very weedless. You can fish it anywhere in the water column, depending on where you, on what size weight you use. And there's a variety of weights, anywhere from a 1/16 to a 1/2 ounce for swim bait hooks. You can fish it from top to bottom. From the top, when you would use a weightless rig, which means you could dart it along the top like a, like to mimic a injured bait fish, or you can fish it on the bottom, like I said, with a weighted swim bait hook. So there's a variety of hooks, there's a variety of weights for them, and all of them put the bait where the fish are in the water column, and they draw lots of strikes. The other advantage of swim baits is the fact that you don't have to rig them at all. They come pre-rigged, some do. This is a Berkeley swim bait that's pre-rigged that looks like a shad, and this is another brand that comes pre-rigged. This one's Texas rigged. So if you want to fish a swim bait, you don't necessarily have to rig your own. You can go out and buy one that's pre-rigged. Now, while swim baits have a lot of advantages that we've talked about, they do have some disadvantages, believe it or not. When you're rigging a swim bait and you rig it weedless, a swim bait is a rather wide bait, which means when you set the hook, you have to pull it through that big bait, which a lot of times, unless you rig it just right, you're not going to hook the fish. So that is a disadvantage. The other disadvantage is the fact that if you use a large swim bait, you got to use a large rod and reel. So what I mean by that is you got to throw it on a big old bait casting rod and reel, and that can become a little tiresome. So those are the two disadvantages, but they're very minimal compared to the advantages of using a swim bait and all the fish you're going to catch on them. Hey, thanks for joining us on this episode of Beyond the Baits, powered by Streamlight. I hope some of the information contained in this video will help you become a better bass fisherman. For more information about bass fishing and other outdoor topics, join us at gameandfishmag.com or pick up a copy of Game and Fish on a local newsstand near you.